Today I'm going to be examining the differences and similarities between The Hunger Games and Battle Royale. First off, let's take a look at the use of violence in Battle Royale. This movie has been quite controversial over the years due to its large content of violence. But why is it so violent? The answer lies in the cinematography. All of the deaths that occur in this film appear on screen, so the viewer gets the full experience of the murders, blood,
gore, and everything else.
In addition to the sight of the murder, the types of cuts and the use of sound enhance the already violent images. Most of the action in Battle Royale is portrayed with a very few cuts and is shown from every angle. This multiple angle perspective allows the audience to see the full extent of the damage, as seen in this clip. Since there aren't many fast cuts, the viewer is easily able to see everything that is occurring on screen. Add to this camera techniques like the swish pan, and you get a much more violent scene. Also, the use of music adds to the suspense and viciousness of each murder. For example, in this scene, there is no background noise. However, once the two characters come into the same frame, music begins to play. In each scene where someone is about to die, the music slowly begins to crescendo, reaching its peak when the death occurs, only to fade away after the deed is done. This has the effect of building suspense in the audience by allowing them to know something horrific is about to ensue. Saku, it becomes clear why his films display such a large amount of violence. World War II had a significant impact on Kenji Fukasaku. After the attacks, my class had to dispose of the corpses, he said in an interview with Tom Mess. It was the first time in my life I'd seen so many dead bodies. Fukasaku's films portray the gruesome reality that is war. Lots of people die in my films, he said. They die terrible deaths. But I make them this way because I don't believe anyone would ever love or trust the films I make any other way. As a contrast to Battle Royale, we have The Hunger Games, directed by Gary Ross. In this example, no death is shown at all. Instead, all the audience gets is a view of the characters and a scream to indicate that something has happened. The extent of the violence is left to the imagination of the viewers. But in the few instances that deaths are being shown, they are mostly hidden by fast cuts and low angles. The fast cuts make it so that you can never actually get a large sense about what is going on. The audience only sees fragments of the action. In addition to this, most of the violent scenes are shot from a low angle that is just above the victim. As a result, it is clear why he chooses to use this type of violence in his films, and how he accomplishes it. This makes it so you can't see the extent of the damage that is occurring, and the result of the violence is left to the imagination of the audience. The low angle effect also gives the victims a sense of helplessness, as those who are stronger seem to tower over them. Director Gary Ross did not have as influential a background as did Kenji Fukasaku. This, in part, is why The Hunger Games was not created to be as violent as Battle Royale. After examining each film, it can be seen that violence plays a different role.